Blessings, family. Welcome to my channel. What a great blessing to connect with you once again. And today I've come your way to speak on five dreams that reveal who your enemy is. Now, people of God, I want you to know, as I always share in my videos, that as we dream, the Spirit of God or God communicates to us. And in our dreams, we receive insight. In our dreams, there are things that are revealed to us. Now, these dreams that I'm going to talk about are dreams not to be taken for granted. When you see these dreams, you need to pray about those dreams, because God could just be revealing your enemies to you. Now, people of God, I want you to know that when people are around you, many a times they don't show that they'll be your enemies. They will be there in your life trying to fulfill the agenda of the enemy. Many people only find out when the damage has been done or when the harm has been done, to say that friend that was in my life was not correct, or that family member that did this was not correct. I didn't know they were pretending. Meanwhile, they were my enemies. So when you see these dreams, it is very much important that you pray about them and allow the Spirit of God to be able to give you guidance on how you should go about. And also remember, people of God, that there are far too many people that will be smiling with you on the outside. Meanwhile, on the inside, they are not smiling. Meanwhile, on the inside, in their hearts, they are angry. Meanwhile, on the inside, in their hearts, they want to harm you. Therefore, we cannot just rely on the outside. We need to be able to ascertain from the Spirit of God on who's who, and be able to know when God shows us certain things in dreams, that we are able to interpret it well and we can take the right steps and the right actions. Now, first dream that I'm going to talk about is when you see a familiar person that is close to you, fighting you in a dream, and you wonder, how can this be? A person you are close to fighting you in a dream. But in real life, you've never fought. In real life, there hasn't been any issue. You need to start to pray for God's protection and for God to change the attitude of that person. Sometimes the people start well, but we all know everybody will change. A person change, you can't trust. It's only God who is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Evil can enter the heart of man. So that's the first dream I'm going to talk about. The second one is when you see a person attacking you in a dream. It could be physically attacking you. Some of them, they might even be having a weapon. They could be verbally attacking you in that dream. Then in this dream, definitely the Lord has revealed your enemy. If the person is not an enemy, then there's no way that they will come in a dream and begin to attack you or try to harm you. If a person is in a good relation with you, if there's a misunderstanding, you can talk things through. There's no reason to attack the other person or try to deal with another person in a way that will harm them. The next dream is when you see a person pointing any weapon at you. When you see this, you need to be careful of that person in real life. They are dangerous. You need to be careful, which means in that dream, the Lord is trying to reveal that kind of person, and the Lord has revealed their identity, which means they're pointing a gun, or maybe they've got a certain weapon that is dangerous, that is meant to harm you, which means those people, if you continue to move with them, your life will end up in danger. It can even end up in death. So it's important that you deal with that kind of situation. A person that is slandering you, or defamation of character in the dream, yet in real life you are in good terms with the person, it means that God is revealing this person, that this person behind your back is busy with your name. You are trying to do something, but the person is trying to cancel it by defamation of character and by ensuring that there is slandering concerning your name. So when this happens, you need to keep a distance from that person in real life. And the last one is when you see in a dream, when you are trying to advance in life and you are being shown in a dream that there is always this person that is blocking you, or this person is pushing you back, or there are dreams that people see. Maybe you're about to enter in a car and there's this person that comes, don't enter into the car. Or when something good is about to happen, there's this person with the same face coming, don't enter. But in real life, this person is closer to you. There is, you know, no issues, which means you need to be careful. Remember my other videos on what a vehicle means in the dream. It means progress. It means movement, motion from one place to the other. So which means that particular person is trying to fight your progress when you see them trying to stop you when you're about to make a movement. And also, people of God, when you dream of this, you need to really take it in prayer. You need to pray, because it's not about now you go and do a physical fight. You need to do a spiritual fight and allow God to have his way and allow God to show you the way to go. And also, one thing that I'd like to highlight, that's why every dream is supposed to be prayed on, because some people see things in dream. Some people can be masked. They can show you a person that is not really your enemy, but they can show them in your dream trying to harm you. Meanwhile, the real enemy is covering behind that mask and is using the face of maybe the person that is meant to help your life. So which means that in that sense, you need discernment. You need to really be able to tell that here, this person, they're using their face or they are masking them because this person is helping me. So they're trying to use them to appear in my dream in a bad light so that I will not take any help from them. So having said that, people of God, these are the dreams that reveal your enemy. These are the dreams that the Lord will show you to reveal enemies that are around you, and you need to pray about them and begin to ask God to help you. Ask the Spirit of God to reveal more and to guide you on what you should do concerning what you have seen. May God bless you all, and I love you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Shalom to you all. See you when I come your way with my next video.